Welcome to another episode of Qt Widgets and More. In this episode, I will give you my top 7 list of shortcuts in Qt Creator. Doing Qt Widgets and More is really just a side project that I have inside of KDAB. My real work is being HR director, controller, and many other things. One thing I observe when I do interviews with people and I ask them to do a bit of live coding is their lack of ability to take this thingy here and throw it out. Keyboard shortcut, I can't emphasize enough how important it is. It's important for 2 reasons. First of all, you save a few seconds every now and then when you don't need to grab your mouse and go somewhere. But much more important, there is the context switch in your brain when you need to find the mouse and move it to a menu and do something. So by all means, the best tip I can give you, do learn your shortcuts. So let's get started. Shortcut number 1 is inserting include files with the keyboard. Come on, Jesper. How would you otherwise do? Okay, you got me there. But using a shortcut then. Let me show you what I mean. I want a checkbox here, Q checkbox. There we are, Q checkbox. Now I could go up here and say, okay, I want a Q checkbox. So hash mark include Q checkbox. And there we are. Did you observe how long it took me to go up there? And especially now that I need to find my way down to where that section was again. So let me just undo this here and go down here again. Else, enter, and it offers you to include the checkbox. And I'm still at the position where I was before. And now observe also that now I can actually be really short, QCB for Q checkbox. There we are, because there are capital letters in here. So Q, instead of writing checkbox all the way out, just QCB, and there's quite a few, so OX for checkbox. Enter, and there we are. Just the other day, I observed somebody in one of those test tasks that needed to go from a CPP file to the accommodating UI file, and he did so by going to the browser in the sidebar and finding the UI file there that matched the name of the CPP file. It took him almost a minute that took him completely out of what was he going to do in that UI file. So let me show you tip number 2 and 3, namely how to jump between CPP file and UI file and how to jump between CPP file and header file. So all that it takes is to remember one magic key binding name, namely F4. So F4 jumps you between the header file and the include file, or the CPP file, the header file and the CPP file. And then when you remember F4, you just need to add shift to it to get to your UI file. So shift F4 to jump between the CPP file and the UI file. There are many things in this world that there's not enough of. I'm sure my boss would claim that the key thing is ice cream. For me, it's screen real estate. I want as much of my screen available for my editor. So get rid of everything else. I'll show you 2 key bindings for doing that. The first thing you want to get rid of is this sidebar over here. What does it help you when you're doing your coding? Can't you figure out how to navigate around your source code? Of course you can. So let's get rid of that one. I could go down here and I could click this button here to make it go away, make it come back, make it go away. Or I could realize that this bar down here, it's all about the L key. So L1 to go to the issues, L2 to go to the searches, L3 to application output. And if you go the other way, 3, 2, 1, what's over here? L0. And you toggle, the bar. So L0 to make it go away whenever you really need to look something up there, L0 to make it come back in. That's one. The other is if you are in a debugging session or you've been looking a bit of help, not much help available here, it seems, something, well, how do I get that one to go away again? I press escape, 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 escape. I haven't really figured out, never had the attention span to figure out how many times escape to make things go away. So it just goes like this. Yeah, just like the gaming in the good old days. So the 200s, yeah, I lost track of what number I made it to. The next keyboard shortcut I'm going to show you is all about how do you paste. How do you paste? Control V? Or do you want to go find your mouse and right click? Okay. If you're not at Control V stage yet, go away. Now I'll show you the smart way of pasting. Imagine this setup. I want to copy and paste the combo helper here because I need combo helpers there and I need it here and I don't know. And I also need the Q overload. I need that here too. And oh, by the way, I need the combo helper. Oh, okay, down here, cut again so I can put another combo helper there. Oh, now I need an overload. Instead of Control V for pasting, Control Shift V. And it'll bring up a list of your previous things that you actually pasted in or copied into your clipboard. So a history of previous pages. Pastes. I've totally lost count of how many shortcuts I've shown you. And the reason is that during this recording, I find more and more shortcuts that I want to show you. So let me just show you the next two, actually, shortcuts. These are for navigating around. So I'm reading my source code here and I'm wondering, what is this good thing really? So I could go and select it and possibly search for it. No, F2 is all I need. F2 will jump me to that location. So that was the first of them. The next one is Alt Left for going back to where I was called from. The F4 and Shift F4 and all of those that we saw before will of course not help me because here I am in main window. Now I'm in, well, mainwindow.h. Okay, bad example. I want to see combo box here. So now I'm in main window. Now I'm in combo box.h. But Alt Left to go back to the previous places I was and Alt Right to go forward again, just like a undo redo stack, but just with precisions. Super useful. And now to the final one, the best of them all, the true time saver. Are you ready for it? Inserting virtual functions from the keyboard. Well, with a shortcut. So here I am. I just created myself a new subclass of Q abstract item model. And of course, I was a bit stupid when I wrote it like this. I should, of course, have gone Control N, chosen Q item model. It would have inserted all the virtual functions for me. But just imagine that this was your own class, that you had a base class that you wanted to subclass and override a number of virtual methods. Here is the time-saving trick of them all. You go up to after the class name, and then you press Alt, Enter. And it offers you insert virtual, blah, blah, from, and here we are. Now I can choose from Q objects. Nah, I don't think I want any of those. I definitely want index and parent and And then I can choose how I want them to be inserted. Should they be inserted into my header file, outside the file, whatever? You really just choose this once for how your likings is. So insert definition into my implementation file. And I would like to add override here, and it should say override. It could have been Q_override if I was stuck in the past. Okay, and here are all my virtual methods, and they are even implemented over here. At 4 o'clock tonight, I will wake up. And I'll think, why did I not show them this shortcut or that shortcut? There are many useful shortcuts in QCreator. Maybe that's material for another episode. But until then, go to this URL here, which will give you a quick reference card to QCreator. I'm Jesper Pedersen. You watched Qt Widgets and more. Until next time, have a great time.